Hello and welcome to our new video. Today a topic we have been wanting to do a video about for a long time, and that is the automatic labeling of sheet metal parts. This has always been possible with SolidSteel parametric, but in the new version 5 this function has also been revised, and it is a function that can really save a lot of time. The big advantage in version 5 is that we can now create and manage templates for different joints from a new menu. So in this case we want to create an end plate connection. We'll create a new template that will support automatic labeling according to our specifications. I'll just copy the default end plates template by clicking Create Default Copy, and for the demo, I'll just save it to the desktop. Now I just open that file. We get a warning that the file is in an older format, but we can ignore that. It's just that we ship our templates to be backward compatible to SOLIDWORKS version 2018. Anyway, how do we get the automatic labeling on this sheet? Basically, we have to take a little detour because the user-defined property of our position number that we want to write on the sheet does not yet exist. Therefore, we can't reference it in the SolidWorks sketch function. So we take the detour and create a new user-defined property called labeling. And now here in this column we want to reference the position number using the normal SolidWorks functionality. So $PRP:\KLPOSNR:\ As an evaluated value we get an error because the KLPOSNR does not exist yet, but we can ignore that and click OK. We create a new sketch on this face and declare that we want to place a text layer on top of it. We assign a label property to this text layer. We simply mirror the text, we will see why I am doing this in a moment, and confirm. We can now position the whole thing, I'm assuming 65mm from this side, and maybe 50mm from the bottom. We may have to adjust this position depending on where the holes end up. But of course with the new connection utility it's easy because we can create multiple templates for each occasion. We're going to save this, and of course if you look closely you'll see that there's an evaluation error here. But that's not a big deal, we'll see how to fix that in a moment. We'll open the settings, select the end plate templates, where we then add our new template. Select the file we just created and give it a name. Click on that template, and our new template will appear in the list. Now for testing we're going to add an end plate using the normal end plate tool. We want to create an end plate between this profile and this surface. Select a standard. It was even pre-selected here, and here we simply select our new template. We confirm and now the end plate connection is added as usual. That means, the end plate is created, holes and bolts are added, the welded assembly is created, the profile is cut, and so on. And now, here on the other side, we can already see our evaluation error on the end plate. But that's not a problem, it's just that we haven't defined the property yet. To fix this, we're going to do a position number update first. And we can see here that our end plate has been given the number 2000. And now we need to rewrite the metadata, which means that the item number will be written to the user-defined property of this end plate. Now we see our position number 2000 on the end plate. I mirrored the text because otherwise there is a risk that the label will be hidden by a weld. In this case, it would have fit, but on the back the numbers are easier to find on the construction site. In the DXF export, of course, we can now output this label as well. All we have to do is assign a job number and activate the export of sketches in the export options. We confirm, the DXF file of this end plate is generated, and now we look at the result. The DXF file is located in the previously selected folder, and they're in a subfolder for sheet metal parts with a thickness of 30mm. Okay, now this is upside down, but that is not important for production. In any case, the label was generated automatically and could now be transferred to the end plate in your production, for example with a laser. This automation means that there is no longer any risk of position numbers not being transferred, parts not being found, etc. In our opinion, automatic labeling saves a lot of time, not only in the creation of the templates but also in production, work preparation and later on the construction site. Of course, the assembly in this example is very simple, but for larger designs with many different sheet metal parts in large quantities, you will save a lot of time compared to adding the labels manually. If you want to create some of the end plates without labels, that's no problem either, then just use the standard template file again. Well, that's it for this topic. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and of course like the video if you enjoyed it. See you next time!